Today, Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV, we're in Venice, Louisiana. It's almost winter, and for the first time in almost 10 years, the Mississippi River is low, which means the salt water has moved up the river, and the speckled trout and redfish have followed. Today, we're with Captain Brandon Ballay of Venice Outdoors, and he's going to take us to a spot right off the Mississippi River, and we're going to catch speckled trout, redfish, catfish, and more. It's unbelievable this time of year with the low river, and you're about to see it right now on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. Closed captioning is brought to you by the Delta Marina in Empire, Louisiana, featuring newly renovated cabins on the water, a ship store for all of your tackle and food and drink, live shrimp, gas and diesel, a fish cleaning station, and the Ponderosa Grill and Oyster Bar serving South Louisiana cuisine Thursday through Sunday. Visit us online at thedeltamarina.com. Our plan for the day is very simple. Captain Brandon's been on a really good trout bite in a deep canal that's right off the Mississippi River, but you can't access it through the river because there's rocks there, so you have to go the back way. So we managed to get in the back way, and he was confident that we were gonna start catching speckled trout when we got there, and that's exactly what happened. Speckled trout and much more. What a morning in Venice, Louisiana.
There's one. There we go. Oh, Venice, yeah. This time of year.
Well, it's a rare treat this time of the year.
Oh man, it is awesome. Come out here with Captain Brandon Ballay. Look at these trout. Look at the, what I like about this is for the first time in years, we have had a low river. And when you have a low river, these speckled trout move in and you catch them. That's what it's all about, man.
It's been 10 years since we've done this. For this long of a time. Yeah, we had a few days where in the last couple years where it got down low for maybe 3 or 4 weeks, but it's been low now for going on like 2 months, and the trout have just went crazy. But yeah, what we're doing, we got a main little cut coming right off the river, and it's just a deep hole. So that's kind of what you look for, is those drops. You know, we got 2 to 4 feet of water right in front of us. It drops off right here to about, but it drops off to about 10, 11 feet of water, and that's where they're sitting. They're sitting right in that little bowl, and they eating basically anything that comes through. They, you know, the river's loaded with shrimp right now. I've seen more shrimp popping on top of the water, and a lot of it, you know, they come in, we catching them, they coming in with shrimp whiskers hanging out their mouth. So you know they're eating the shrimp, but they also eating pogies. A lot of pogies in the river too right now, little small pogies, you know, 3 inches. There you go.
Ooh. And they're nice trout too.
I tell you what, these are actually a little bit better than the ones we had the other day.
But you said the key to the whole thing is to make sure you're fishing 3/8 and you get on that bottom.
Yes. And sometimes, and you've probably heard about it, a lot of times we'll double rig. We'll make a double rig. And that's the only reason we go to that is when you got a lot of current. When you got a lot of current, you need to go to that double rig just so you can get down.
Well, it's also fun because you may catch two.
Well, you do catch two. Especially when they're biting real good, you'll catch two. But it's mostly, the most reason of it is for the current.
Yeah.
Because you know you want to hop it off the bottom and then let it fall right back down. So you're only making like little 6-8 inch hops, and then the bait just falls right back to the bottom, and that's when they grab it, right when it makes that fall.
the boat. I tell you one thing, for this water being as cold as it is, buddy.
They are quite active.
They are quite active. I mean, that's... But that's what happens when that river gets clean like that. I mean, we are right off the river, and look how clear that water is.
Yep.
Now, normally when you're fishing down here, you're going to fish... You can usually be safe with purple and chartreuse, black and chartreuse. I'm actually fishing with a purple Little John today from Mirror Lure. Little scented bait, straight tail bait. Decided to throw that, and they're hitting it too. But if you look at the bellies on these fish, and we don't see any shrimp whiskers yet, but we're probably going to see one.
Oh, I missed you. I guarantee you, they in there.
Ooh, that one hit it good.
Ooh, that was a good one.
That would be a catfish.
Nah, ain't no catfish. It could be now.
That's a catfish.
There are some.
No, that's a foul hook trout.
Oh,
here you go.
There you go.
Catch him in the behind. Oh. Well, gotta love it.
Caught many a bass on that corner up there.
There we go.
Got him.
There's one.
Yeah. Oh, here he comes. There he is. Yep. That's a trout. Oop, way back up. Get out your way.
There we go. Another good one. Just let it get in the current. You can see that current's flowing right down here. Those fish are so pretty. That was close. But Venice speckled trout. And the fun thing about it is, Brandon, you can always, you know, back in the day when we're talking about when we had the low rivers, you just get in any of these ditches. I mean, you can get in a ditch half the size of this one and catch these fish. It's amazing that these trout will get in these areas. But the key is, as Brandon says, is you want to have shallow, then deep water. Where they get in this deep water, it gets cold, they'll get right on that bottom, and you're going to catch them.
Maybe that's my problem, I'm throwing too far.
I love them. So, Brandon was telling me, now we're catching speckled trout right now, but Brandon, the one thing that you were saying is you can catch a variety of fish out here, huh?
Yes, a lot of the other species, the sheep's head, and freshwater catfish. I mean, this time of the year, you get in these deeper holes, the freshwater catfish are in here. I mean, I've seen guys come to the dock with just the ice chest full of them. Mm-hmm. And they're all about 2 to 4 pounders, which is a good eating ones. You know, like I said, we're targeting speckled trout, so we throw an artificial, so we're kind of not going to have the, you know, we're not going to catch too many of the other species, but the sheep's head, flag drums, redfish, flounders, they're all in the same holes.
Yeah, so you can come out here, catch a lot of different fish, but you get in these deep holes and go bounce an artificial off the bottom.
You never know what you're going to catch. But we, like I said, we're targeting speckled trout, so that's our choice.
Yeah. And if we had live shrimp on the bottom right now, it would probably be just not even fun.
Well, it would be very easy.
It would be just...
Yeah, it would be very easy.
That's a...
I tell you what, he looks good.
He's mad. Ooh, Venice speckled trout. Captain Brandon Ballay. It's amazing what happens when that river goes down, man.
It does.
It's just
Earlier during the summer, it was fairly hard.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, a double.
I lost you, Kevin.
Brandon, you hooked one.
Dude,
you were so mad at that fish.
Well, he caught me with my hand on the remote. I was adjusting the boat a little bit.
You know what's surprising to me?
Oh,
besides the fact that you just caught a fish.
Oh, okay.
No, I'm just kidding. What's surprising to me is it's warm out here, but that water temperature is cold, and these fish are acting like it's the middle of summer.
They are definitely active, but if, yeah, you grab them, and it's like grabbing ice.
Yeah.
You know?
I mean, you'd think the way that fish hit it was 90 degrees.
Yeah. Yeah. He smacked it. I finally connected.
Here's one. Now that one there, he just barely tapped it.
You are on fire.
Barely tapped it. Well, look at this. This is like the middle of summer fish.
Yeah, because sometimes this time of the year you catch them and they just basically lay there.
Yeah, they just lay there. Oh, goodness.
Yeah, well.
And, you know, a lot of times we talk about seasons and when this lasts and when's it in. It had nothing to do with the season. It's got all to do when that river comes up.
That's out. That's right.
Because these fish will be here until the river comes
this
up.
This will happen until the Mississippi River in New Orleans gauge, I would say, gets around 7 or 8.
Oh, there you go. We just moved up a little bit. Double trouble now.
We just had to get a better angle on the hole here. Tell you what, this one's got... Look at this.
Oh, that's
one.
A nice fish. Look, is that a white trout?
No, it's a speck.
Oh, that's a good one there. That's a good one. That's a good one. Brandon, how about... You know, we're catching fish a lot right now, but that's beautiful.
That's actually a pretty doggone good one.
Yeah. Sometimes the angle of attack is so important, isn't it?
Yes. Well, you know, you got to try to match with the...
Look, as soon as it hit over there, they're over in that flat.
Yeah, well, it's 8-9 feet of water right there.
But that one, as soon as it hit the water, that one hit it. This is pretty cool. All right, yeah, this is... Hello, welcome to Venice.
Yeah.
Oh! Hold on. Almost. Come up here.
We got him.
All right.
I saved your rod last time. I saved your fish this time.
Oh, yeah. Hit it as soon as it hit the water. Water! Way back in that backpack there.
Oh, he's sitting on that corner right there.
Yeah, look at this. It's every... Now, this is getting to be insane. I mean, these fish are something. So...
I didn't reach the hole.
You didn't reach the hole?
Look at that.
All right, there's your little John, my mirror lure, by the way. Lovely bait, straight tail, scented, purple, 3/8 ounce, death grip jig head. That's the ticket.
You over the rocks right there, just FYI. Oh, I'm back here, Kev.
Oh, I'm over the rocks? Is that what that is?
You had a rock. You're gonna come off the rock.
Is that...
And what you got, redfish, bass, what?
I don't know what I have.
Well, I got a speckled trout.
Oh my gosh.
You have a redfish.
Or a catfish. No, redfish. Look at that. That's pretty awesome. Hey, Kev, you're on the rocks. No, I'm not. I'm not on the rocks.
If you're going to prove me wrong, at least you did a good job of proving me wrong. Now, I forgot my net at the house, so I'm not really sure what you're going to do with it.
We're gonna.
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, we're gonna bass fish. Ooh, that's close.
Wait.
You're not gonna whip him?
No, I'm not gonna whip him. He got that big old.
Ooh, that's a pretty
heavy
red.
Heavy jig head on there. That's a perfect red.
That is a perfect red. How about that? Yeah, I like fishing them rocks.
Well.
I thought I was on that rock. I swear, as soon as you said that, I jerked it right off the rock. I thought I was jerking it.
Well, I remember earlier I saw a fish strike out there, and it probably had to be him.
Yep.
Yep.
Big old fat redfish.
Perfect. River red.
Yep. Boy, as soon as it hit over there again.
You gotta let the spot rest for a minute.
Yep.
And some new ones keep moving in.
As soon as it hit the water.
Get out your way.
Golly. Amazing fishing down here today. Don't need a measuring stick.
No.
Don't even need one in Texas or anywhere else with these fish.
Yep. They're all at least 15 inches.
But it's so pretty. If you want to come down here to Plaquemines Parish, Brandon talked about all of the different fish you can catch out here, but it's foggy this morning, like real foggy. But when it's not foggy, the ride out. You know, Brandon, so many customers enjoy just the ride out, going through the delta. I mean, that's just...
Especially this time of the year with all the birds, the waterfowl, you know. People are like in awe when they see all the ducks jumping up as we're running by. Of course, this morning, all we could see was the radar and the GPS. We just took our time, went slow. So we missed that aspect of it. But yes, that's most people's... One of the funnest parts of the whole day is the ride out and in.
Yeah. You know, for us, we want to get out there and catch the fish. Right. We see this every day, but you come out here this time of year, oh, there you go, you're going to see waterfowl.
Oh, I had him. I was jigging him with one hand there. And
you're going to see all the waterfowl and everything.
Right.
In the summertime, you're going to see the alligators. You're going to get out in the bays and see the dolphins. So there's so much more to this area when you come out than just catching the fish. I mean, it's amazing.
I saw him when he hit it.
I swear, folks, I promise you we're fishing. Oh, double trouble.
Right there, oh.
I promise you we're fishing in December. I promise you.
Yes.
These fish coming out the water. I promise you it's December. Yours is like 13 inches and it looks small.
It looks tiny compared to your fish.
Yeah.
LOA TV is brought to you by the Chandelier Islander Fishing Lodge, full service, all-inclusive meals and lodging in the heart of the Chandelier Islands. Come stay and play in paradise. How the Pros Do It is brought to you by the Louisiana Charter Boat Association. Visit lasaltwater.com.
So when you come to finish this, it's big and it's intimidating, but what you really want to do on a low river scenario like we have today, or we have this fall, is you want to concentrate close to the main river itself and on the main passes. You got three big passes, Pass Alutra, South Pass, Southwest Pass. The fish are in all of them. But you want to get right where you have a cut coming out the river, whether it be a restricted area or a diversion or the spillways or whatever. And the fish are going to be right inside of them on the drop-offs. Typically, you got shallow water close to the bank, and then it drops off into the middle of the canals. And, you know, just sometimes you got to drift the canal. Sometimes they right where the canal intersects or something like that. But pull up, make you 10 or 15 casts. You don't get a bite, go to the next spot. Or...
Oh, God, did he whack the hell out of it? These fish are dancing out the water.
I love your enthusiasm, Kevin.
Yeah, you do?
I do. I mean, you act like, you know, you've
I've never done this before.
Yes.
This is my first ever trout.
Yeah. I believe that. I believe that.
Probably a lot of people do too. There he is.
Hey, what you got?
Redfish.
Are you calling redfish?
Yeah,
yep. I'm calling redfish too.
Redfish.
Let's see.
Oh, catfish.
There you go.
Look at that big old catfish. Oh, that's a big old cat.
Oh, and he swallowed it too, didn't he? Wow.
That's a nice fish there now. We talked about the variety of fish you could catch.
And this
freshwater cats too.
I can't even see it in there. Oh, I see it. It's way down there.
I think I got another one of your catfish.
Yeah. You are thrown in a secret catfish hole. Yes, it is. I see him rolling.
No, redfish.
Oh, redfish. Okay.
Pretty redfish. Look at that. Beautiful red. Beautiful redfish.
You never know what you're going to catch.
Nope. Nice.
You never know what you're going to catch.
I like your redfish, catfish, speckled trout hole.
We have caught redfish, catfish, and speckled trout out of that hole, yes.
Well, what there is right there is there's some rocks, and you can feel, because you told me, you told me where to cast.
Yep.
And if you cast where those canes are right there, you can, you hit the bottom, you're gonna hit a rock. But right when it comes off those rocks, that's where those redfish are gonna ambush.
Well, we are out of time, but the bite never stopped. We caught more redfish, more catfish, more trout, even a bass and a flounder. What a morning out here with Captain Brandon Ballay, Venice Outdoors. Come to Plaquemines Parish in Venice, Louisiana, and get in on this great action. This is truly a paradise in South Louisiana. For Captain Brandon Ballay and producer Jim Caesar, I'm Kevin Ford. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.